Hello and welcome back to my channel Get Coded, and today is class 4 on HTML. In last class we discussed about paragraphs, break tags, horizontal rules and finally the pre-formatted text. So in today's class we would be learning about the formatting elements. When we talk about formatting elements, it means about styling and about meaning of the text. So in formatting elements there are two types that we are going to learn. The first type would be the font formatting and the second is the phrase formatting. The only difference between the two is in font formatting we focus upon the styling of the text, whereas in phrase formatting we focus upon the meaning of the text. We would be learning about phrase formatting and font formatting in details in this class. So let's just write down the basic structure of our program. And in this structure, we would be starting with the basic font formatting tags. So the first tag that we are going to learn is the bold tag. So to write some content within the paragraph, a sample content. Okay, so this is the content that I want. And in this, if I wish to make the sunburn as a bold, I have to place my sunburn in the B tag. Okay. Open and close B. For the convenience, I am going to write break after each statement. Okay. To see the bold, we will just go to our folder and we will run this. So you can see our sunburn has become bold. Okay. Then the rest of the text. Second tag that now we are going to focus upon is, I will just separate this content that we are mainly focusing on from the rest of the content. Okay, so the next tag that we are going to refer is the strong tag. So instead of B, I will write strong, and here also strong. So when I save it and when I go to my page and refresh my page, you can see there is no change that has happened here. Okay. So what is the difference behind using these two tags, that is the bold tag and the strong tag? The difference is about the importance. Okay. So if you want to give more importance to some kind of text, then you need to use strong tag. Otherwise, you can use your bold tag. Okay. Similarly, if we go to check the I tag, which makes our text in italic. So when I refresh my page, you can see my text has now become in italic. And there is another tag called as a EM tag. This EM means emphasized tag. Okay. So in this emphasized tag, our text still remains in italic only. Okay. So the difference here is again about the importance of our content. If our content is more important, then we are going to make the use of emphasized tag. Otherwise, we would be using italic tag only. So the next type of tag that I am going to show y'all, the mark tag. This mark tag would basically highlight our text. Instead of all this content, only sunburn will get highlighted. So if I refresh, I guess I did not save, so after saving I will refresh and you can see that the sunburn has got highlighted. This was about the mark tag. Our next tag is the small tag. This tag will make our text appear smaller in size than the remaining text. Okay, so when I save it and refresh it, you can see the sunburn has become one size smaller than the rest of the text. Coming to the next type of tag, that is delete and insert. So delete will delete the sunburn. Okay, so these have attributes called as the site attribute and the date time attribute. When I refresh my page, you can see this strike on my sunburn, which means that this text was deleted. If I use the insert tag, it will insert sunburn within this context. So when I save it and refresh it, you can see it got underlined. Okay, means our text was inserted. Next are the famous tags, the superscript and the subscript tag. So first we are just looking in the subscript tag. So if there is H2O, you can know that H is capital, then 2 comes down and then comes the O, right? Let's try. If I refresh, you can see H, the 2 is down and the O is again on top. So the text which you want to make down, you need to insert that text between the sub tag. Sub means subscript. Okay. Second tag that we are going to focus on is the superscript. So instead of SUB, we would be writing SUP, and now this 2 will come above the H and O. Okay. So if I refresh, you can see the 2 has now come above the H and O. So this was all about the font formatting. So now let's focus on the phrase formatting. So in phrase formatting, the first phrase formatting tag that we have is the Q tag. Okay. So Q tag is basically the quotation tag. So in quotation, if you want to write anything, you can write. For the time being, I am writing sunburn and saving it. So when I refresh, you can see the sunburn has now come in the double inverted tag. That means this is now a quotation. It is a short quotation, you can say. So coming to the next type of tag is the abbreviation tag. Okay, so instead of Q, we are going to write ABBR, and here also ABBR. So abbreviation will give the browser the information that this is some abbreviated text. So if I write, for an example, if I give the title here name as let's say WHO, that means World Health Organization, right? So here comes the World Health Organization. Okay, so inside this I am going to write WHO. Okay, and save it. So this is going to show us some abbreviation on our browser. When I save it and refresh here, you can see there is some underline here, which means our text, our browser knows that this is the abbreviation for World Health Organization. You can see there is a tool tip available here for us to know what is WHO. So it means World Health Organization. Now coming to another type of tag, that is BDO. Okay, so BDO means bidirectional override, and it is the element that is used to override the current text direction. So here instead of this we will write BDO, and here we have to give the direction like how it should be. So in reading we read from left to right, so here I want it to appear from right to left. Okay, so our WHO is now going to appear in OHW. Okay, so I'll just close this BDO tag, save it, and when I refresh it, you can see WHO has now become OHW. So there are other tags available as well, which means the address tag, the site tag, the KBD tag, SAMP tag, code tag, and finally the var tag. So that is it for today. If you like it, do like, share and subscribe to my channel. Also press that bell icon so you don't miss any regular updates about my channel. I post every Monday and on Wednesday, so make sure you subscribe to my channel. Thanks a lot for watching.